Lady May, Tyler Childers, let's get at it. All right, Lady May is recorded in standard tuning. You're just going to need a capo on fret 3 in order to play along with the recording. And there are really only about 3 or 4 chords, not too many. There's a C chord. We're going to be doing a lot of stuff with our middle finger on the C chord. Then there's an F chord right there. Again, same thing with that. A lot of stuff with our middle finger on the F chord. And then there's A minor, kind of a G over B. He doesn't really play the whole thing. You just kind of hear the walk up on the B. And then back to the C again. And that is all of the chords that you will need for this entire song. Let's go ahead and learn how to play the intro. All right, let me play through the intro once very slowly, and then we will go ahead and break down what I'm actually playing. So what we do is we start on the C shape, but we're going to start on the D string with our middle finger and go 2 open. Just kind of pick it once and then pull off. Then we're going to hit the 3rd fret on the A string, so kind of the root note of the C chord. 3 hits on there, then open D to the 2 on the D string. We're gonna go and pull back off. So far we've got. After you hit those 3 notes on the C, you can kind of strum the next, the D, G, and B strings basically. You don't have to be too precise on this song. I see a lot of other tutorials where they're, you know, every single string all the time. I don't think that's how Tyler plays it. He's just kind of free flowing throughout. Then we're going to go to the F chord, and we're going to play 3 on the D string. Then we're going to go open to 2 on the G string. Then we're going to do the same thing, but switch back to the C chord. So that's 3 on the A string and open 2 on D. All right, what we just learned was this. Then we're gonna go back to the F chord. And right there, we're going to hit that 3 on the D string, open on the G, 2 on the G, back open. Again, I'm kind of playing those G and B strings both. Then we're gonna do a quick pull off walk down on the D string. So that's 3, 2, open. And we're going to end on 3 on the A string. But you only want to strum or pick the D string once and let your fingers do the pull-offs. And then pick 3 on the A string as well. So far we've got this. And then we're gonna go that walk up. And really all he's playing is basically the A string. You can do a little bit. So your first finger is resting on, relative to the capo, fret 1 on the B string this whole time. So that walk up is, you can kind of pick that G and B string on the upstrokes. And then we're gonna go 0-2 hammer on the D string again. That is one time through the intro. Again, we start on the D string. Then he just repeats that all over again. So the main thing that you have to get down is where those hammer-ons from 0 to 2 are, based on if you're on the C chord or on the F chord. It's just a lot of middle finger up and down. That's the intro. The verses are not as much so intricate picking. We're just kind of feeling around the C and the F and still doing those hammer-ons as well. Or the main thing to remember during all of the singing is just where he does those walk-ups from A minor to the B to the C. So I will kind of walk you through those, but he starts on the C chord. I'm a stone's throw from the mill, and I'm a good walk to the river. I'll kind of, as I play through this, I will put the chord diagrams in the bottom corner. But it's really just pay attention to where those hammer-ons are. You're never really strumming like full chords. When you're playing this song, I think the most important thing to remember is just kind of strum it lightly. So right there, we're doing. I'm a good walk to the river. So you're just kind of hitting the root of those notes and then hammering on from 0 to 2 with your middle finger based on what chord you're playing. I'm a stone's throw from the mill, and I'm a good walk to the river. My working day is over. We'll go swim our cares away. Put your toes down in the water, and a smile across your face. Tell me that you love me, lovely Lady May. So really, as long as you get down where those chords are, you can even just play it straight if you want to. You don't have to do those hammer-ons, but it's that's technically how he plays it. Then we get into the first chorus. We start off on the walk up, A minor, G over B, C. Now, I ain't the sharpest chisel that your hands have ever held, but darling, I could love you well till the roll is called on high. And I've seen my share of trouble, and I've held my weight in shame. But I'm baptized in your name, lovely Lady May. Then he goes into the intro twice. We already learned that. Verse 2 is the same as verse 1 as far as chording goes. Actually, chorus 2 is the same as well. Like I said, the only thing that you need to remember is where those walk-ups are. And he kind of puts them in different spots throughout the song. So what I did when I was first learning this song a couple years ago is I printed out the lyrics, and then I just kind of highlighted where those walk-ups were, you know, on kind of the phrases, and that helped me learn where they are. But that's basically the song. Once you learn the intro riff and then you're just playing chords throughout, it's a pretty easy song. So let's go ahead and do a playthrough together.
When my working day is over, we'll go swim our cares away. Put your toes down in the water, and a smile across your face. And tell me that you love me, lovely Lady May. Now I ain't the sharpest chisel that your hands have ever held, but darling, I could love you well till the roll is called on high. And I've seen my share of trouble, and I've held my weight in shame. But I'm baptized in your name, lovely Lady May. Though the wind can leave you shivering as it waltzes o'er the leaves, it's been rushing through my timber till your love brought on the spring. Now the mountains are a-blushing and they don't know what to say, except a good long line of praises for my lovely Lady May. Now I ain't the toughest hickory that your axe has ever felled, but I'm a hickory just as well, I'm a hickory all the same. I came crashing through the forest as you cut my roots away, and I fell a good long way for my lovely Lady May.
Well, hey, I hope that tutorial helped you learn how to play Lady May by Tyler Childers. It is a pretty easy song once you get down that main picking pattern. But if you need help with something or if I didn't explain something clearly, just be sure and leave me a comment in the section down below. I try and do my best to answer and interact with each one of you that do, and just appreciate that. If you haven't already, be sure and subscribe to the channel, like this video, comment, do all the YouTube stuff. It greatly helps me out a ton, and I appreciate your support in watching these videos. As always, leave me a comment below if you want to learn another song. I'll add it to the list. But other than that, thanks for watching this video. See you next week.